Hello, it's Polish Paul VR, welcome to my channel, and it's time to review Bullet Sorrow, a latest PlayStation VR game, and a game that continues the very nice trend that started somehow last year during Aspyr 1 release, which is basically giving PSVR owners all the shit games. I mean, it's nearly March, and what we've had good so far, just Shadow Legend, and that's all. So anyway, let me review this game, the Bullet Sorrow. I spoke about it in my PSVR Super Show, and I said, yeah, demo was not too bad, I would like to play a bit more, but little do I know, the demo was like pretty much whole game gonna be. Nothing changed, basically, you are, I don't even know the story, it's being told to you by somebody talking to you, I don't know who that is, something about humanity being fucked, I don't understand, because clearly developers didn't even care that much to tell the story. But what you're doing, you're shooting loads of enemies, they're running at you, you're in little area, once you clear the area, you can move forward. You got a bit of freedom where you can move around, but sadly it's teleportation and click turning only. You're shooting them by holding your move controller in very strange upward position, so you can teleport with one move and you can use your bullet time capabilities with other move, the time slows down and then you can start shooting. The problem with it is once you kill everyone and you're still in bullet time, before you progress to the next area you have to shoot like a sign what says shoot, and then the game will let you go further away. But what's happening is in bullet time this sign can take ages to appear, so you're just standing there doing nothing. And then you cannot even stop bullet time, there is no meter on it, you don't know, I don't know, it's a guessing game when it's gonna deactivate and when you can activate it. But anyway, that's pretty much the gameplay. Along the way you can pick up health, you can pick up shield, and also you can pick up different weapons. Tracking is not that great, and with 200 weapons, tracking is terrible, so I've been trying to avoid those. Also, there is moments when you can grab this big, massive machine gun and like shoot everyone, but you're grabbing it automatically. It don't feel like you're even holding it and your character just likes to let go of it every now and then. Very, very annoying. You've got three stages and you've got endless mode, which is two spawn points, spawning enemies and you just shoot them. In the end, I was like, I will let somebody kill me because this is just draining my soul. Now, the bugs in this game are very nice, there is very plenty of them. The enemies walking through each other, walking through the environment, you can even teleport sometimes inside the environment, or somebody might stand inside you. Also, some enemies, when you shoot them, especially the ones with the shield, they kind of like wrap itself into its own body, and it just gives you that hilarious look. Definitely seems like a very unpolished game. Graphically, it's not that great as well. It's, you know, it's quite poor texture-wise, quality-wise. It's got those blobby texture, Nintendo 64 style. It's a cover shooter, and yes, you can hide, you can cover, you can duke, and that works alright. The last stage of the game, I enjoyed that one the most. I wish they did more of that. Also, at the end of each stage, you've got bosses, and first boss is alright, it's a robot, it tells you where you shoot them. Other bosses, you've got some two samurai ninja magic chicks flying at you for some reason, and also you're fighting a giant spaceship. But they are bullet sponges, so the fighting eventually becomes boring. Sound-wise, the game don't have 3D sound, so you don't know where people coming from. You know somebody is coming, but you're like, where is he? Behind me? In front of me? Because the game got that 360 degrees play area, so you can like move around, they stand behind you or in front of you. You've got your click turning, of course, but like I said, you never know where your enemies might be. Especially if you're facing forward and somebody runs behind you, but it sounds like it's somewhere on side of you. So the sound is pretty broken, the soundtrack is bad. Last level got like an epic soundtrack that lifts the atmosphere a bit. But all in all, this game, I just didn't have a good time with it. When I played the demo, I said I would like to play more of it when I play PC demo. But I was thinking the game will evolve and it won't be just what it was. So what I'm seeing, it was a very bad game. And also it's super, super overpriced and I don't know what's happening. But PSVR owners this year keep getting shit games. Anyway, the final score is 3 out of 10. Bullet time can feel good and also cover system works. And apart from that, everything else can be pretty, pretty bad. And the game is super way more too expensive, twice as expensive as on PC. And on PC they've got multiplayer and shit. On PSVR it's only single player and this endless mode. There is no options unless you want to change language. You can choose three different difficulties, but why would you want to, because it's all boring. Okay, if you like what you're seeing, then please press a like, because it does helps the channel a lot. And if you're new to the channel and are not subscribed, then subscribe. It's always better when it's more of us. And that's it, bye.